So yesterday, Sayaraji informed that the number 3 and 4 obstacles to the concentration, the Lina Chaita and Atipakita Chaita. So Lina Chaita means the inductive mind, and Atipakita Chaita means over enthusiastic mind. So the first one, the Lina Chaita, a negative mind, naturally followed by laziness. So we have to make it active and fresh, pay more attention to the object. So thus we can overcome the laziness and make the mind stable. So Sayaraji explained about that in brief yesterday. In the literature, this Lina Sutta is elaborated. So Sayaraji will explain some more about Lina Chaita today. And another number 4 mental state is Atipakita Chaita, over enthusiastic mental state, or over-concerned mental state. So that's the mental state of over-enthusiasm or over-concern is followed by the udajja, or restlessness of mind. So that's also the obstacle to the concentration. So when you find your mind over-enthusiastic, over-active, then you should make it relax and calm and relax, and then mind becomes stable and concentration can take place. So yesterday Sayaraji explained about that too, yesterday. So in the literature they explain the laziness, the discussion manner of behavior in detail. So today Sayaraji want to explain further about the laziness according to the Pali canon and commentaries. So for the beginner yogis, especially this laziness or lethargy or thought and torpor is the immediate enemies. They all the time interfering with the practice. So we need to make great effort, courageous effort, and heroic effort, so that we can defeat the enemies. We have to make the firm determination to overcome such a lazy mental state. We must be alert, active all the time to face with the enemies. Just like in the battlefield, in front line of the battlefield, we must be alert all the time so that we can take one step ahead of the enemies. Otherwise, we will be definitely defeated by the enemy. So in the same way, so we are in front line of the battle with the enemies or laziness. So we must be all the time alert and active and fresh, so that we cannot be defeated by the enemies or laziness, and we can take one step ahead of the enemies. So this enemy, including the other mental defilements, they are not the ordinary enemies. They are enemies throughout samsara, throughout the sangha or rebirth. So we must be courageous. We must be brave to face with such a strong, powerful, mighty enemies. So in Pali it's also called metta, or normally translated as laziness. It's actually very immediate or inner element. It's very often come and discuss concentration. So we need to learn how to fight such an internal enemy according to the Pali text. So after having practiced meditation for some time, for a long time, then you cannot reach the certain level, or you may think you cannot make progress in the practice, then your mind is become slow and no longer active. That's a great obstacle to concentration. That mental state is followed by the laziness. So to prevent such a laziness, we need to know how to prevent and or how to cure when it takes place. As the saying goes, prevention is better than the cure. So that we need to know how to prevent the laziness from arising. So the yesterday Sayadaw explained about the right aim. So we have to aim our mind at the meditative object. This aiming is directly opposite to the laziness. The aiming mental state can counteract the laziness directly, and it also can make the mind fresh and active. So it is very important to pay our attention to the object, or to focus our mind on the object, or to aim at the object in such a way that the mind penetrate into the nature of the object, characteristics of the object. So in this case, the courageous effort or heroic effort also essential, which can defeat the laziness. So two factors are very important to counteract the laziness and then to defeat laziness. The right aiming can counteract the laziness, and the courageous effort can get rid of the laziness. So these two factors are very important to overcome laziness. If the laziness takes place, all we can do is just observe it and note it, and we can overcome it. In this way, our mind can become fresh again and become stable. And this, Sayadaw explained this text yesterday. But sometimes there is options we need to learn to overcome these laziness, the mental state of laziness. So in the Pali text, when the Buddha described the Viriya Vajjhanga, one of the important factors of the enlightenment, that is the effort, great effort. So the Buddha explained about the great effort, one of the factors of enlightenment, in a very simple way. The Buddha described the effort as a courage. There are three kinds of courage: Arambha Dhatu, Nekama Dhatu, and Prakama Dhatu. So three kinds of courage is explained in the Pali text. So these are one of the factors of the enlightenment. So first of all, Arambhadhyani is normally translated as launching energy, the courageous energy, inertia energy. So first of all, the yogis here, they learn about the Sthivatthana and its benefits. Hearsay or from reading the books and so on. And they have more or less faith and confidence in the practice. So they become brave and courageous to practice Sthivatthana. So they are brave enough to leave all their family and business and some other worldly affairs behind. So that's the courage. That's a type of energy, launching energy or initial energy. And also the foreign country, there's the difference, different food, different culture, and some other difficulties. So you are ready to face this problem. So you are courageous, you are brave to make effort. That's initial courage for the Arambhadhyani. And also when you arrive here, you start your practice, observing the starting from the rising, falling on your abdomen or your walking. You start to learn the simple lessons of all the practice, and that's the initial practice, initial energy, courage and effort. That's for Arambhadhyani, the launching energy or initial effort. And this way you nurture and cultivate your faith and confidence in the practice and make effort. So as mentioned repeatedly, you pay attention to the objects, or you aim at the objects correctly, and you put great effort in the practice, and then you start to experience the real phenomena. So every object, or every rising falling, or every step, or every activity, you start to know everything as much as possible, whatever occurring to you. In this way, you start your meditation practice. So you are very courageous, and you make courageous effort. You make launching energy. That's called Arambhadhyani, a type of courage, the launching energy. So we have to make launching energy, or we have to arouse the courageous effort in practice, so that our noted mind can go directly to the object. So noted mind and noted object can take place concurrently. So in the beginning, however, you may miss many objects. So then you have to adjust. So how to catch the object without missing it. So you have to check yourself whether your noted mind goes straight to the object or not. And if you find your mind goes the other way, then you have to keep the yoniso manasikara, the right mental attitude. So the right mental attitude, through the right attitude, you have to direct your mind straight to the object. And then your mind will go to the object directly. That's a type of energy anani or launching anani. So when we make the energy anani, when we arouse the energy anani repeatedly by guiding our mind to the object from moment to moment, the viriya, the energy gain the momentum, that become more and more powerful. So the benefit is we can overcome laziness, or we can get off the laziness. So overcome laziness means there will be no room left for the laziness. So we replace laziness with the effort. We don't leave any room for laziness. We leave no room for laziness. So that's all the eradication of laziness by replacing laziness with the energy. So all we need to do is we have to note the whatever objects occurring to us, starting from rising, falling, and so on. So every moment we have to make effort and aim our mind at the objects, and then there will be no room left for the laziness. That's the immediate benefit we can gain from the launching energy or the initial effort. So while you are making effort, sometimes the laziness may come to pervade, may have an upper hand on you. Then what you have to do? Do you want to give up? Do you want to surrender? If you want to give up, that means you are not brave, not courageous, you are coward. So never give up, never surrender. Instead, you have to raise up your courageous energy and face with the enemies. Otherwise, you will be defeated by the enemies. When we encounter the enemies, if we are coward, we will be definitely defeated by the enemies. There will be no chance for us to attack the enemies. So we must attack the enemies with a courageous effort and energy. In this way, when the laziness comes to prevail, comes to be powerful and overwhelmed, then don't give up. Instead, we have to raise up our energy and promote our energy and fight it again. So such energy, such courage is called Nekama Dhatu, the progressive energy or progressive courage. Yeah. So in order to develop five mental faculties, the Buddha said that we should not care about our life and limbs. We have to make effort, great effort, irrespective of life and limbs. So when we encounter during the intense practice, for example, the pain, so sometimes we are afraid. Maybe this pain is so severe, or that I cannot be bad, or this pain may lead to the severe lifelong problem. Or maybe this pain leads me to the stroke. So you magnify the problem. So just like, actually, sometimes You see the pain are more severe. The reality that means you see the pain more clearly. Pain itself is not actually increasing, but you see more clearly, just like seeing the pain with the powerful glasses or microscope. Anyway, in that case, you will see despite it. You may want to give up the practice. So that's why the Buddha encouraged us to make great effort without caring about our life and limb. As you know, there are four factors of the Buddha energy. So we have to let our bone and skin remain, let our flesh dry. I will give up my effort, my practice, until I reach what can I reach with the many effort. So you have to make such a strong, firm determination to overcome such a covetousness. So this courage is called Nikama Dhatu. Through this Nikama Dhatu, through this courageous effort, or this energy, you keep on noting the pain, for example. Then you find the pain as pain. Pain is pain. Nobody is dead. So you experience only pain. You cannot find nobody there, or you cannot find which part of the body the pain is arising. It is in the buttock, or in the knee, or in what part of the body. You don't know what part of the body the pain is arising. All you know is pain is pain. No form of hands, or leg, or head, or nobody involved in that pain. Pain is pain. You can see pain beyond the form or shape. Then you don't need to care about your life and limb, because you don't find anybody involved in that pain. Thus, you can find the pain as a pleasant pain. So in this way, you can overcome the pain with a courageous energy, courageous effort. So when you overcome the pain, the joy or happiness naturally take place, and which followed by the tranquility and the concentration. So that concentration is very powerful, enough to defeat the pain. So that's why that concentration is honored as a samadhi kriya, one of the faculties, mental faculties. So when we practice the observation of the pain, dukkha vedana, we have to arouse the nikama dhatu, the progressive energy, without caring about our life and limb, so that we can overcome we can deal with the pain, unpleasant sensation, and keep our mind stable and tranquil. So that type of mental faculty is powerful enough to overcome restlessness of mind, samadhi-indriya, the mental faculty of the concentration. So first of all, we have to nurture our concentration through the launching energy, the first kind of courage. And then we have to boost up, or we have to promote it through the nekama dhatu, the progressive energy, or second kind of the courage. And later we have to promote our energy until we reach what we want. We reach the goal. What's our goal of the practice of meditation? Just for tranquility? Or we want to apply the, we want to use meditation for tranquilizer, sleeping pill? Or we want to get megaphone enlightenment? What's our purpose? What's our goal? We have to try our best to reach, to meet our purpose, to reach our goal. So we have to make effort until we reach our goal. So that energy is called the culminating energy, the prakama dhatu in Pali. The energy, the courage, which can lead us to the goal we want, or the purpose to meet. So there, you may have the different purpose to come and practice meditation. So the correct purpose of the meditation is to overcome the internal defilements, such as the greed, anger, hatred, and delusion, ignorance, and so on. So we need to set up right goal. We must have right, correct purpose. So some people, they may have the wrong purpose, false purpose. One of the writers, Western writers, he described the drugs, and the, like the opium, the how powerful and how enjoyable the use of drugs is. He recommends the drug abusing. Compared with the drug abuse, the meditation practice is totally superior. Actually, if you're using the drug with the desire to enjoy the certain kinds of the feeling, finally you will become a drug addict, and you will definitely fall victim to the drug. So that's why they found the Satipatthana meditation as a replacement of the drug. But such a purpose is not correct. The Satipatthana meditation is not a replacement for the drug. So the drug using and drug abusing and meditation practice is totally different. The purpose also totally different. So we need to have correct purpose, correct. We need to set up correct goal. So we have to practice, make great effort to reach that real goal, to meet the real purpose through the three stages of the courage, three stages of the energy, arambha dhatu, nekama dhatu, prakama dhatu, the launching energy, progressive energy, culminating energy. Through these three stages of energy, we can We should practice until we reach the real goal, until we meet real purpose. So in this way, we can develop our energy, you know, step by step until we reach the enlightenment. And also we can become courageous enough or brave enough to face with any difficulty, any problem in life in this way. So in conclusion, Shara make wish, may you be able to arouse such a courageous effort and energy according to the Buddha's teaching, and may you be able to deal with any kinds of difficulty in life. That's all for today. Sadhu, 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 sadhu.